What's up, guys? Welcome to the Stats Free Sports Channel. Let's get right into it. Here to bring you a prediction video on Chiefs running back Clyde Edwards-Helaire. I believe he'll be traded to the Seattle Seahawks. Now, let's get right into it. So, Clyde Edwards-Helaire, to me, is on the outs in Kansas City. It was really, really big news before the offseason started, or right in the early part of the offseason, right before free agency started, really. It was big talk about him being moved, him being cut, traded, something happening, and then it just went dead silent once all the news started going on. And even still now, around this time, it's almost draft time, it's super quiet on his front about him being moved, him staying, or something. I believe Jerick McKinnon is still a free agent for the Chiefs. I think he'll be picked back up by the Chiefs also. Obviously, Isaiah Pacheco is still there. So I think, you know, I think his time is kind of done in Kansas City. Had a good run there, was a valuable weapon for a couple years, but it just seems like, you know, he just kind of lost favor and kind of lost his touch in Kansas City. But a new team like Seattle would be the best fit for him, honestly. I did a prediction video on the Seattle Seahawks being a dark horse team for a guy like Austin Eckler. And that was right after they lost Rashard Penny to the Eagles, which I figured he wouldn't be back anyways. But, you know, that does leave a gaping hole for kind of a receiving slash pass catching back to pair with a guy like Kenneth Walker, who had a good rookie year last season. Kenneth Walker will be in this scenario, whether they get Eckler or whether they get a guy like Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Gonna be, you know, Walker will be the first two down back, and then first second down, and then a pass catcher receiving back like Eckler or Clyde will be the receiving back on third down. So I think to me, it's clear as day he's not really an every down back. You know, he was splitting carries in 2021 and 2021 and 2020. Excuse me, like I was saying earlier with a guy like Darren Williams. You know, he's a decent back, but you know, he's a similar back. He's part of a group. Not really a guy who's going to be leading the show. And you look at the numbers-wise, and I hate looking at numbers, but numbers do show, you know, some truth sometimes. You look at a guy like Kenneth Walker, his first year, you know, only had like 27 catches for 165 yards with no touchdowns receiving. You know, so it's like, man, you know, there's some dynamic receiving role definitely being a hole open for the Seattle Seahawks. You know, and I think a guy like Clyde or Eckler would fit that bill perfectly. I keep saying Eckler because I think Eckler will be traded. I still think that, you know, there is an outside chance that the Chargers could get Bijan Robinson. You know, I think they're drafting at 21 or 27. I forgot exactly right off, but I do think Eckler will be traded. And I have about three teams I've already put out publicly for Eckler. I put the Bears, I put the Lions, and I put the Seahawks. So we'll see if he is moved and where he'll go if he is. But I think, some of these teams who already have a couple backs might make some room for a guy like Eckler, who definitely could be pretty solid. But, you know, and even, you know, going back to Kenneth Walker's numbers, he was even worse in college as far as his pass catching goes. You know, he even, in 3 years in college, he posted 19 receptions for 136 yards and one touchdown. So, you know, history shows, the numbers prove it this time around. You know, I think numbers do lie sometimes, but this time around, numbers show, it proves that you need a dynamic back to go with a guy like Walker. You know, and his history, 4 years of history, 1 year NFL, 3 years of college shows that. And I think a guy like Clyde Edwards-Helaire would be the best fit, honestly. You know, to make this move more clear to me, honestly, the Seattle Seahawks, lost their other backup running back to Walker in Travis Homer. You know what I mean? So he's already out now. He caught 16 passes last season. Last 4 years, excuse me. So it's like, you know, they lost a couple backs now. They need some good depth behind Walker. Why not get a young guy who's only 23, who's got championship and big game experience like Clyde Edwards-Helaire, pairing up with Walker, see what you can do. And also, getting Clyde will be for the super cheap 5th, 6th round pick. He lost a ton of value this past season. He didn't play the last handful of games plus playoffs while being healthy for the Kansas City Chiefs. So it's like, man, you know, his stock took a major drop, as I said, 5th, 6th round probably. You know, so it should be pretty easy to get him. Shouldn't be hard at all. And I think the Seattle Seahawks can definitely pass around a 5th, 6th round pick for some more running back depth. So, you know, You know, all that to me just screams Clyde to the Seahawks. It just makes the most sense to me. You know, the lack of depth, the low draft pick needed to get him probably, you know, and the need for more dynamic play beside or with a guy like Kenneth Walker. Everything, 1 + 1 = 2. I think this is equal, easy as that. Clyde to the Seahawks to me equals the most probable option for a guy like him to be traded. And it makes sense, you know, and where to be traded, the Seahawks. And it makes sense for it to happen during the NFL draft. It just makes the most sense. Day one, day two, day three, doesn't matter. But somewhere around the time, right before, right after, somewhere around that time, Clyde will be a Seattle Seahawk, in my personal opinion. So we'll see when that is. But that's it for video, guys. Like, share, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. What's up, guys? Welcome to the Stats Free Sports channel. Let's get right into it. Here to bring you a prediction video on Chiefs running back Clyde Edwards-Helaire. I believe he'll be traded to the Seattle Seahawks. Now, let's get right into it. So, Clyde Edwards-Helaire, to me, is on the outs in Kansas City. It was really, really big news before the offseason started, or right in the early part of the offseason, right before free agency started, really. It was big talk about him being moved, him being cut, traded, something happening, and then it just went dead silent once all the news started going on. And even still now, around this time, it's almost draft time, is super quiet on his front about him being moved, him staying or something. I believe Jared McKinnon is still a free agent for the Chiefs. I think he'll be picked back up by the Chiefs also. Obviously, Isaiah Pacheco is still there. So I think, you know, I think his time is kind of done in Kansas City. Had a good run there. Was a valuable weapon for a couple years. But it just seems like, you know, he just kind of lost favor and kind of lost his touch in Kansas City. But a new team like Seattle would be the best fit for him, honestly. I did a prediction video on the Seattle Seahawks being a dark horse team for a guy like Austin Eckler. And that was right after they lost Rashad Penny to the Eagles, which I figured he wouldn't be back anyways. But, you know, that does leave a gaping hole for kind of a receiving slash pass catching back to pair with a guy like Kenneth Walker, who had a good rookie year last season. Kenneth Walker could be, well, will be in this scenario, whether they get Eckler or whether they get a guy like Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Going to be, you know, Walker will be the first two down back, and then, no, first, second down, and then a pass catcher receiving back like Eckler or Clyde will be the receiving back on third down. I think it's clear that, you know, even though Clyde was a starting running back, quote unquote, from 2020 and 2021, he still split a lot of carries with whoever he was paired with during those years. You know what I mean? He's fine. Make this move more clear to me, honestly. The Seattle Seahawks, lost their other backup running back to Walker and Travis Homer. You know what I mean? So he's already out now. He caught 16 passes last season. Last 4 years, excuse me. So it's like, you know, they lost a couple backs now. They need some good depth behind Walker. Why not get a young guy who's only 23, who's got championship and big game experience like Clyde Edwards-Helaire, pair him up with Walker, see what you can do. And also, getting Clyde will be for the super cheap, 5th, 6th round pick. He lost a ton of value this past season. He didn't play the last handful of games, plus playoffs, while being healthy for the Kansas City Chiefs. So it's like, man, you know, his stock took a major drop, as I said, 5th, 6th round probably. You know, so it should be pretty easy to get him. Shouldn't be hard at all. And I think the Seattle Seahawks can definitely pass around a 5th, 6th round pick for some more running back depth. So, you know, all that to me just screams Clyde to the Seahawks. It just makes the most sense to me. You know, the lack of depth, the low draft pick needed to get him probably, you know, and the need for more dynamic play beside or with a guy like Kenneth Walker. Everything, 1 + 1 = 2. I think this is equal, easy as that. Clyde to the Seahawks to me equals the most probable option for a guy like him to be traded. And it makes sense, you know, and where to be traded, the Seahawks. And it makes sense for it to happen during the NFL draft. It just makes the most sense. Day one, day two, day three, doesn't matter. But somewhere around the time, right before, right after, somewhere around that time, Clyde will be a Seattle Seahawk, in my personal opinion. So we'll see when that is. But that's it for video, guys. Like, share, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.